Recorded Books presents an unabridged recording of Alcohol by Nancy B. Peacock, narrated by Jack Garrett.
Introduction by Barry R. McCaffrey, Director, Office of National Drug Control Policy. Staying away from illegal drugs, tobacco products, and alcohol. Good health allows you to be as strong, happy, smart, and skillful as you can possibly be. The worst thing about illegal drugs is that they damage people from the inside. Our bodies and minds are wonderful, complicated systems that run like finely tuned machines when we take care of ourselves. Doctors prescribe legal drugs, called medicines, to heal us when we become sick. But dangerous chemicals that are not recommended by doctors, nurses, or pharmacists are called illegal drugs. These drugs cannot be bought in stores because they harm different organs of the body, causing illness or even death. Illegal drugs, such as marijuana, cocaine or crack, heroin, methamphetamine or meth, and other dangerous substances, are against the law because they affect our ability to think, work, play, sleep, or eat. If anyone ever offers you illegal drugs or any kind of pills, liquids, substances to smoke, or shots to inject into your body, tell them you're not interested. You should report drug pushers, people who distribute these poisons, to parents, teachers, police, coaches, clergy, or other adults whom you trust. Cigarettes and alcohol are also illegal for youngsters. Tobacco products and drinks like wine, beer, and liquor are particularly harmful for children and teenagers because their bodies, especially their nervous systems, are still developing. For this reason, young people are more likely to be hurt by illicit drugs, including cigarettes and alcohol. These two products kill more people from cancer and automobile accidents caused by intoxicated drivers than all other drugs combined. We say about drug use, users are losers. Be a winner and stay away from illegal drugs, tobacco products, and alcoholic beverages. Here are four reasons why you shouldn't use illegal drugs. Illegal drugs can cause brain damage. Illegal drugs are psychoactive. This means that they change your personality or the way you feel. They also impair your judgment. While under the influence of drugs, you are more likely to endanger your life or someone else's. You will also be less able to protect yourself from danger. Many illegal drugs are addictive, which means that once a person starts taking them, stopping is extremely difficult. An addict's body craves the drug and becomes dependent upon it. The illegal drug user may become sick if the drug is discontinued, and so may become a slave to drugs. Some drugs, called gateway substances, can lead a person to take more dangerous drugs. For example, a 12-year-old who smokes marijuana is 79 times more likely to have an addiction problem later in life than a child who never tries marijuana. Here are some reasons why you shouldn't drink alcoholic beverages, including beer and wine coolers. Alcohol is the second leading cause of death in our country. More than 100,000 people die every year because of drinking. Adolescents are twice as likely as adults to be involved in fatal alcohol-related car crashes. Half of all assaults against girls or women involve alcohol. Drinking is illegal if you are under the age of 21. You could be arrested for this crime. Here are three reasons why you shouldn't smoke cigarettes. Nicotine is highly addictive. Once you start smoking, it is very hard to stop. And smoking cigarettes causes lung cancer and other diseases. Tobacco and nicotine-related diseases kill more than 400,000 people every year. Each day, 3,000 kids begin smoking. One-third of these youngsters will probably have their lives shortened because of tobacco use. Children who smoke cigarettes are almost 6 times more likely to use other illegal drugs than kids who don't smoke. If your parents haven't told you how they feel about the dangers of illegal drugs, ask them. 1 of every 10 kids aged 12 to 17 is using illegal drugs. They do not understand the risks they are taking with their health and their lives. However, the vast majority of young people in America are smart enough to figure out that drugs, cigarettes, and alcohol could rob them of their future. Be your body's best friend. Guard your mental and physical health by staying away from drugs. Foreword. Why Should I Learn About Drugs? By Stephen L. Jaffe, M.D., Senior Consulting Editor, Professor of Child and Adolescent Psychiatry, Emory University. Your grandparents and great-grandparents did not think much about drug awareness. That's because drugs, to most of them, simply meant medicine. Of the 3 types of drugs, medicine is the good type. Medicines such as penicillin and aspirin promote healing and help sick people get better. Another type of drug is obviously bad for you because it is poison. Then there are the kinds of drugs that fool you, such as marijuana and LSD. They make you feel good, but they harm your body and brain. Our great crisis today is that this 3rd category of drugs has become widely abused. Drugs of abuse are everywhere, not just in rough neighborhoods. Many teens are introduced to drugs by older brothers, sisters, friends, or even friends' parents. Some people may use only a little bit of a drug, but others, who inherited a tendency to become addicted, may move on to using drugs all the time. If a family member is or was an alcoholic or an addict, a young person is at greater risk of becoming one. Drug abuse can weaken us physically. Worse, it can cause permanent mental damage. Our brain is the most important part of our body. Our thoughts, hopes, wishes, feelings, and memories are located there, within 100 billion nerve cells. Alcohol and drugs that are abused will harm and even destroy these cells. During the teen years, your brain continues to develop and grow, but drugs and alcohol can impair this growth. I treat all types of teenagers at my hospital programs and in my office. Many suffer from depression or anxiety. A lot of them abuse drugs and alcohol, and this makes their depression or fears worse. I have celebrated birthdays and high school graduations with many of my patients.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.